Hey, wrong bin, man. That should be recycled.
Why, this doesn't get recycled.
Who told you that?
You think this gets recycled? Come on, why don't you tell me what happens then?
Okay, I will. Let's go.
What happens to your drink containers when you put them in a recycling bin? Are they really recycled? The answer is yes. They are a valuable resource, and when we recycle them, we are helping the environment. In 1975, South Australia introduced the Container Deposit Legislation, or CDL. This means we pay a deposit for our containers when we buy them, and that money is refunded when we return them for recycling. Recycling drink containers is a great way for schools and community groups to raise money. Many schools have set up their own recycling systems, which are managed by the students. Students collect the containers, sort them, and take them to a recycling depot for the refund. There are recycling depots all over South Australia that you can take your containers to. At the depot, they count them and calculate how much money to give you. Schools have used the money to support overseas aid projects or to buy benches and drinking fountains. Recycling depots send the containers to statewide recycling in specially designed cages. So our drink containers are recycled instead of becoming rubbish, and we are paid to do it.
See, I told you.
Well, that's what happens at school, but what about all the stuff that happens at home?
Well, I can answer that. Collecting drink containers isn't just for schools and community groups. You can sort them at home and take them to the recycling depot yourself, just like schools. Or you can put them in your recycling bin if you have one. Off milk or juice causes quite a stink, so it's important to rinse containers before they go in. A truck collects the recycling bin from your curbside and takes it to a materials recovery facility, or MRF for short. There are three MRFs in the Adelaide metropolitan area and others in regional South Australia. A MRF is different to landfill. At the MRF, all of your recyclables are sorted and the deposit containers are separated to be sent to statewide recycling. The MRF collects the refund for these containers instead of you. Does that answer all your questions?
Well, actually no. How do they get recycled?
Statewide Recycling is a super collector of deposit containers. This means they collect containers from other collectors like depots and MRFs. Aluminium cans, polyethylene terephthalate or PET plastic drink bottles, liquid paperboard or LPB milk and juice cartons, and high-density polyethylene or HDPE plastic bottles are processed here. The special cages are brought to Statewide Recycling and are unloaded from the trucks. Some drink containers also arrive in wool bales. The cages are lifted on a tipping frame and emptied into cells to weigh the contents. Aluminium cans drop onto a conveyor belt and are carried to a silo for storage until they move to the baling machine. South Australians recover over 80% of aluminium drink cans for recycling. The cans have to pass under a magnet to remove any steel cans that may have accidentally been mixed with them. Then the cans are squashed into blocks. Statewide processes about 30 blocks a day, holding more than 13,000 cans. A single block can weigh 200 kilograms. PET bottles follow a slightly different process. From the waste cells, plastic drink containers are blown into a hopper. They empty into a rotating trommel so they can be sorted to determine the number of bottles. The bottles are sorted as different sized bottles weigh different amounts and the weight needs to be recorded to calculate the payment to the depot or MRF. The bottles have to pass a statewide employee whose job is to pull out the contaminants or plastic that is not PET, also coloured bottles. A small amount of contaminating plastic can affect the whole recycling process. The coloured bottles are stored and processed separately. On average, Statewide produces 60 blocks a day of PET, but in the summer, this number can increase. Each of the blocks produced weigh about 210 kilograms. Now, I have a question for you. How many bottles are in a crushed block of PET plastic? A, 500, B, 2,000, or C, 5,500?
Probably 500.
Actually, there are close to 5,500 bottles. There are 26 bottles per kilogram, so statewide process 327,000 PET bottles every day. Since 2003, flavoured milk and juice cartons that hold less than 1 litre have been included in the container deposit legislation. The LPB containers are dropped straight on the conveyor belt and are sent to the baler to be squashed into blocks. LPB is recycled to recover the valuable paper in the drink containers. HDPE is processed the same way as LPB. The wool bales with HDPE plastic bottles are poured onto the conveyor and sent to the baling machine. You'll notice that HDPE plastic is quite different to the PET bottles. It is never clear or see-through, and because it is softer, it is also quicker to block. Often the small yogurt drink bottles arrive in separate bags and are blocked in their bags because they can be a problem for the machinery. The blocks of drink containers are stored at Statewide until they are transported to other locations to be recycled into new items.
Okay, so what are they made into?
The blocks of drink containers are transformed into new products that we can use. Blocks of aluminium cans are transported interstate to be recycled to make new aluminium cans and other products such as parts for cars and bicycles. Recycling 20 aluminium cans uses the same amount of energy it takes to make one new one. Clear PET blocks are also transported interstate to be made into plastic drink bottles, and the coloured PET can be recycled into detergent or non-drink bottles. Some PET is recycled into fibre for clothing, sleeping bag fill, or even carpet. Liquid paperboard is made into new paper products. There is enough paper in a single 1 litre milk carton to make up to 5 sheets of good quality paper that can be used for printing, and uses about half the energy needed to make the paper products from raw materials. Some HDPE is processed here in South Australia. It is shredded, washed, and then fed through a machine that turns it into pellets. The pellets can be moulded to make just about anything, including bollards and railway sleepers. Products made from recycled plastic are being developed all the time. Recycling your bottle can help reduce the number of containers being sent to landfill, which helps save natural resources. It can be money in your pocket, and it can help the environment.
It still doesn't say that all containers get recycled.
You want to know why? Do you want me to tell you why? Because it's people like you who are letting us down.